than you expect, Autumn. Automatically set back that moment you realize you have fallen into the hands of the enemy. Satan versus you, the worst simile, yet Jesus shows empathy. Crushing the head of that thing and that thing and that thing that swallowed you suddenly so delicately, how the colors of fall change. Until vibrantly you show your true disdain. Your moods begin to change. Priorities rearrange. Red, brown, yellow, no longer green with life's maze. And Junes and Julys just crushed fallen leaves left to die. Disconnected from the Most High. I don't know. Maybe this is just a season we're going through. The beginning of something new. Well, now's the time. Yeah, we must die. Daily, we must die to become alive. Life is full of hellos and goodbyes. Goodbye to the old man. Hello, morning dew. Captured in the photos of sin, this is God being your photosynthesis, converting his light into you. Fueling your spirit man to become the walking truth. He's your breath of life, your reason for believing. It's time to take flight. So rake your leaves. It's time to clean. Pack up your things. Stuff them in the largest black bag you can find. Get rid of it. You don't even have to turn around to say goodbye. The accuser is trying to enter your temple to stake his claim, and you don't even remember your own name. So instead of falling prey, fall to prey, become the clay that God molds into his beautiful image, the everlasting privilege. You're a part of his lineage. It's about time you start living it. You look better in your future state. It's not too late to win this race. I'd rather fall on my face prostrate rather than give space in my heart for him again. I win. You can win. I win. I will speak it again and again. I will speak it into existence. I win.
Amen.
Winter arrived
as the warmth of last words left my lips. The heavy front door slammed. Insecurities had muttered their snarky hello, shoving past me into my single window room. They collapsed on my mind like a body into a favorite chair. Cold like the air outside the glass. Through silence, they yelled their familiar questions. And yeah, I had a few victories that day, but I still didn't have any answers to their favorite opening line. Has God made a way yet? Turning my back on things I can't see with eyes fixed firmly in reality, I sigh within my mentality and long, slow. No. See, in sunlight, the crisp air on the wings of the Holy Spirit cheerleaded words internally defending me from my previous midnight. With the beams on my back, I built my esteem in my mind, but in winter, the sun runs for covers earlier and earlier, and it felt like even nature knew what time it was for me. They say it's a cold, cold world out there, and I felt that definitely. So with the moon catching a glimpse of itself on the big mirror on the far side of my room, fear snuggled up close like a second skin, and we remembered every single one of my failures again. Nothing like the end of something to bring you back to the beginning. Where hope and pride make you feel like you're winning. When you have joy and the air is gathering beneath your wings and it feels like a shade-free blue sky is full of pride. That was the joy of my dream before I found myself looking at eyes I didn't recognize, asking Jesus why. Why did I have to climb through the roughest, darkest, hardest parts of life? Irritated, I even once told him that it didn't take this much hardship to make me pay attention. I know that God hears my prayers, but it doesn't feel like he's listening. Because doubt keeps asking me questions. And anxiety, an unofficial watchman, keeps yelling at me, asking me, how long will I wait? And confidence is like a magician that pulls disappearing acts over and over again. And courage, I have to beg to stick around day in and day out, because if I don't, fear drags sadness out of her house and we spend all night mopping up buckets that she's been storing up. I need this season to go because it's taking drinking everything I had to simply hold. Opposite of spring, where buds bloom into flowers, there is no growth here. So here's to hello. Because if I say goodbye one more time, even I'm going to believe it's a lie. Spring came that year. Bittersweet. Hindsight is what they call the best sight. I'm sure looking back allows you to remember where you were, forces you to acknowledge what you didn't know. My mind was fresh, ready to embark upon what I thought was the start of my red carpet runway. You know how you walk with your head held high, feet falling in the perfect stride, proudly prancing through Lilith, looking like, they ain't got nothing on me. Smack dab in the heart of my hopes, I was gutted of all my desires, laying against the ropes, open and exposed, vulnerable to the harsh rain's pour. I realized there was no cover, no shade tree to hover or block me from the vindictive elements. So I put on the face, played the part people want to see. I looked resilient, I looked victorious, but I didn't believe my own facade. The truth was, I was crushed to the marrow of my bones. Broken past the point of put the pieces back together. Everything in me wanted to crawl into that dark hole that called my name on those lonely nights. But someday, someway, somehow, somewhere, somebody kept me, pushed me, held me, and consoled me, comforted me in a manner that passed even my own understanding. See, people needed to know, wanted to know, thought they knew but didn't have a clue. I can't tell you how, I can only tell you who.
Come on. Yeah.
So I was consoled, all the while unfolding the treasure this vessel had been holding. I'm beholding my face in the mirror as he does the molding. And though it was a little touch and go there for a minute, let me testify. See, I had to fake it to make it. I had to not feel, because the alternative was my mind. He comes to steal and kill. And though I didn't see my joy being ripped apart and my confidence being eaten on by sadness, I could smell her.
Come on.
The sense of the soul rotting, dying. His task is to destroy. Yet in his sovereignty, the master, that is, he mapped out each step, saw each footprint, spoke into each path, detailing my destiny. Y'all might laugh only because you don't understand. If it were up to my grasp,
come on,
I would have let go. My prayers were so bleak, I didn't even know what to ask. Hurt making me focus on my past. Y'all, I'm telling you, I wasn't gonna last.
Come on.
But life is full of hello and goodbyes. So I had to take off that mask and wave farewell to the old man and his lies. I've made it through some tough rains that often made it hard not to complain. Along the way, I have gained some growing pains. I've learned how to call on Jesus' name.
Hallelujah!
After these showers, there will be harvest, there will be fruit, there will be gladness. I don't accept anything less. That would be madness. On us all, a little rain must fall. Don't give up before you witness the flowers. Then is the sun at its brightest. He'll never leave you, especially in the darkest hours. Greets us all with kisses of gold, bronzing fair tones and converting natural fresh tresses back to coils again. Breeze rolls against the skin of mankind and nature alike, like drool down a baby's chin. Grins rise at the rays of the sun, piercing through billows up yonder, as if El Shaddai has winked his eye at us himself, causing our fearful minds to remember that he alone is sovereign and just, providing us with just enough of all the right ingredients that make us full grown. Ask King Solomon, for he has told us, or take a look at Job, for his life has shown us good times never last long enough, but they do last long enough for our hands to grasp them and pocket them in jeans we call memories deemed precious, washed with prayers that they never fade, like the old photos of those who have long gone on before us. Here's to
lasting friendship. Ties of love formed through commonalities and differences. Those glimpses of Eden experiences when perfection is realistic, even if only in instances that can be measured and weighed. See, the reason summer is the longest season is so that the good can exceed the bad at the culmination of our days. So here's to the taste of sweet victory after perceived defeat. Here's to every test, every trial that has served as a capsule for our faith's increase. Here's to joy unspeakable and everlasting peace, God's loyal love and tender mercies. Here's to every time we have ever smiled, laughed, danced, sung, or hummed out of an attitude of gratitude. Let these moments be the fuel for our praise that gives us strength in the later days when the seasons change before our eyes. Sure, life is full of hellos and goodbyes, but let us resolve, yes, you and I, let us resolve to always, always remember and thank God for the warm greetings of our summertime. Summer, fall, winter, revolving doors we're forced to enter. Ready or not, we must enter them. Pleasant or not, we must enter them. For God is in them all.
Amen. Amen. Woo!